The Flying Girl, How Aida de Acosta Learned to Soar. One day, a girl named Aida was strolling on a lively street in a lovely city when she glanced up and was dazzled by the sight of a huge balloon that glided as gracefully as a whale-shaped moon. Below the balloon, an airboat dangled, and inside there was a man. "If that man can fly, so can I," cried Aida. "All I need are some lessons and a chance to try." Aida's mother scolded. "No, no, no, silly girl, don't be so bold. Ay, 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 no one will ever marry a girl who dares to fly." But Aida had a dream now, a wild dream of soaring, and she did not care to marry anyone who thought dreams were boring. So Aida asked the man to teach her the art of airship flight. The inventor of airships, whose name was Alberto, agreed to show Aida how to start a motor and steer, turn left, turn right. Lessons on the ground weren't easy, but Aida worked hard and soon learned how to pull this lever, tug that rope, drop more ballast, believe, practice, hope. One evening, Alberto invited Aida to an aerial dinner with tables as tall as elephants, served by waiters who walked on tilted stilts. That made them look like silly giraffes. At dinner, Alberto said that his airships were meant to be chariots of peace, so that people all over the world could meet one another and develop friendships by flying back and forth. When Alberto invited Aida to ride while he drove an airship, she cried, "No, no, no. Ay, 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 I won't be a passenger. I only want to be the pilot." Alberto was amazed. Aida was just a teenager, and no woman or girl had ever flown before. But no one had believed Alberto's wild dream of motorized flight could come true either, not until he invented his airship. So Alberto realized that if he could fly, Aida could too. All she needed was courage and a chance to try. On a clear summer day, Aida finally had her thrilling chance to pull this lever, tug that rope, drop more ballast, believe, rise up, hope. Like a whale-shaped moon, the airship's enormous balloon soared above the busy city and out to the countryside. It sailed over green farms and cows and sheep, high above the heads of excited children who cried out, "Look, look, it's a girl, and she's flying." From her dangling airboat, Aida smiled down at the children, but then she frowned at Alberto, who was on the road far below, frantically pedaling his bicycle and waving his handkerchief as he tried to show her which way to go, even though she had already told him that she did not need help because she had practiced. Alberto got tangled in a thicket of trees and fell far behind. Aida kept flying high above the roads and rivers, completely alone, totally free, until finally she reached her destination, a green field where swift polo ponies twirled and leaped like dancers. Aida landed skillfully, planning to watch the daring game, but down on the ground she soon found that she could not climb out of the airboat. Her dress was too fancy and the skirt was too tight, so she wriggled while children giggled until in the end some helpful men had to tip the boat sideways so that she could slide out, almost gracefully, without too much of a bumpy, toppling tumble. Aida tried to watch the horses, but angry strangers surrounded her, shouting, scolding, calling names, saying she was too bold, too brave, too different, too strange. Girls, they hollered, should only be allowed to learn to cook, sew, and clean, but girls, they bellowed, should never be taught how to fly huge machines. Just then, Alberto finally caught up, still pedaling his bicycle, eager to cheer her. You did it, he shouted. You flew. You're a hero. Such a brave inspiration for all the girls of the world. Aida smiled. Aida laughed. Yes, yes, yes. Aye, aye, aye. She really was the first. But she was sure she would not be the last. Every child who had seen her glide so high above the roads and fields was probably already singing. If that young lady can fly, so can I. All I need are some lessons and a chance to try. Sometimes, Aida said to Alberto, all it takes to change the world is one wild dreamer's soaring example.